Hello everybody, Teagan here with High Point. Thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's episode of What is in the Night Sky this month. I'm going to be taking you through a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of April. So as always, buckle in and let's see what's really out there. So the first stop on our tour is a celestial event, one that can be overwhelming and life-changing in nature. On April 8th, a total solar eclipse will occur, and many of those in the United States will be able to witness it. Let's talk more about this event. For observers in the United States, the total solar eclipse of April 8th isn't the event of the year, it's the event of the decade. The path of totality begins in the South Pacific and first hits land on the western coast of Mexico. It'll then head northeast before crossing into the United States to the southwest of San Antonio, Texas. It will pass over Austin, Killeen, Dallas, and Fort Worth before moving into Arkansas and passing over Little Rock. Next, it will move through Missouri and then into Indiana and Ohio, where residents of Indianapolis, Dayton, Northwest Columbus, Toledo, and Cleveland will be able to experience totality. Lastly, anyone living in Buffalo, Rochester, or Syracuse, the exact details will vary depending on your location, so be sure to check online for specific information. So while nothing on this list really beats the experience of viewing a total solar eclipse, we're going to stay within our neighborhood and we're going to see what the moon and the planets are up to this month. Unfortunately, both Venus and Neptune are lost within the glare of the sun this month, but you might still be able to glimpse Mercury very low in the west shortly after sunset for the first week. Jupiter is also still clinging to that evening twilight, but may prove to be challenging by the time May comes around. Take a look with binoculars at about an hour after sunset, and you may be able to spot Uranus within the same field of view as Jupiter. The two will be closest on the 20th, but by that time the pair will be too close to the sun for Uranus to be visible. Your last chance may come around the 10th. In the morning sky, both Mars and Saturn are edging away from the sun and can be seen shortly after sunrise throughout April. Like Jupiter and Uranus, they're also within the same binocular field of view until the 19th. And lastly, for the moon, it turns new on April 8th, and then a pink full moon will occur on the 23rd. So as we travel out past our own solar system and past the farthest reaches of our galaxy, we end up at Messier 66 and Messier 65. There are an abundance of galaxies to be found in the constellation of Leo, with M66 and M65 arguably being the most popular. Both of these are easy targets for small telescopes, but will fit into the same low-powered field of view. Be sure to check out for NGC 3628, otherwise known as the Hamburger Galaxy, just to the north. This galaxy group is also known as the Leo Triplet and is a famous group of galaxies to photograph. If you're new to astrophotography, you can photograph this trio with a wide-field telescope or something a bit more narrow. We are going to stay within the realm of the constellation of Leo for this next target. We're also going to stay within the category of galaxy pairs. M95 and M96 are Leo's other famous galactic pair. They are about the same brightness as M65 and M66 and lie to the east, a little more than 2 degrees south of K Leonis. Both are visible in small telescopes, with both showing bright stellar cores. For our next target, we're going to bring it in within the reaches of our own galaxy, and we're going to visit Messier 97, a beautiful planetary nebula known as the Owl Nebula. Although located just 2 degrees from Mirac and the Big Dipper, M97 can be a challenging target as its light is scattered over a comparatively large area. This makes it difficult to detect, and a large telescope may be required to see the dark patches that give this nebula its name. If you have a longer focal length telescope, like an SCT or a Newtonian, or even an RC, this can be a great target for your hydrogen alpha and oxygen filters. So the next target and the last on our list in the month of April is Melotte 111, also known as the Coma Open Cluster. Under dark skies, you can see the Coma Cluster with the naked eye, but otherwise, it's an easy and pleasant target for binoculars. Look roughly halfway between Core Coroli and Canes Venatici and Denebola and Leo for a sparse scattering of stars. This is one of those star clusters that, no pun intended, really shine through a pair of binoculars. It can be a little too wide for telescopes unless you are using a very wide field refractor and a very wide eyepiece. So with all that being said, thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's episode of What is in the Night Sky this month. Be sure to look online on the link that we've provided in the description for more information on the path of totality for the eclipse this month. It is going to be a jaw-dropping experience. Please be sure to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you do not miss any future content on all things astrophotography and astronomy. Again, I am Teagan. Thank you so much, and clear skies.